emerging SME segment in the country has never been more empowering in the new normal as we break through with resilience and grit to recover and adapt to digitalization through the entrepreneurial spirit. In a time when community centers, home-based businesses, and aspiring local entrepreneurs are responding to the daily needs of Filipinos today, data connectivity has never been more significant for everyday living. Converge Business SME Services is at the forefront of this breakthrough. From the humble beginnings of Dennis Uy, Converge Business aims to serve the underserved, believing that we can grow our own small businesses, that we are all SMEs. Making Converge Business as your primary source can boost your advantage and growth. With its world-class fiber optic network, micro entrepreneurs gain more advantage in the current digital arena with robust technology that can seize opportunities to go all digital. Entrepreneurs humbly begin with a vision to grow and expand through their passion and determination. In the competitive business landscape, small to medium enterprises need to adapt services and products to reach more Filipinos here and around the world. As a primary provider, Converge is a world-class ICT company with the most resilient and superior fiber optic service in the Philippines that continues to delight millions of its users in the consumer space, serving a growing number of business clients in the SME, enterprise, and wholesale segment. Converge Business is for SMEs, providing a partnership that offers subscription models that allow businesses more options and flexibility. It is your own gateway to the world, a partner to springboard your success. Leveraging on our strong network architecture, Converge Business can provide impactful broadband solutions to your business. With Converge Business SME Services, equip your business with the right tool to jumpstart your progress to the next level. We leverage on innovative technologies to bring you what matters: results. It is time to be in control. Converge Business SME Services. Results mean progress.
The Filipino entrepreneur is innovative, you know, that's one, no? And they are very creative also. That's our things, no? And not just on that, they are really think out of the box. You are innovative guy, you know? You deep thinkers. So when the pandemic hit us, this SME, if they have fast thinker, fast innovate and fast transform, went to digital, there's a lot of opportunity. When you have the basic requirement to transform into digital during this pandemic, is the digital highway, which is, lucky enough, this is my business. And we built this digital highway for the transform of these SMEs. You know, I think this is sort of like a survival. Eh? No? Well, when you start in hardship, in you grow up with a hardship. No? During my younger age, hindi ko natikman yung tipong you have this good opportunity to play with your classmates. Whatever spare of time I have, I want to maximize my time. When I start really small. No? This is really SME type. My technical, I have employee number one still with me. I'm the one driving and climbing the pole to lay down these wires. I seen the technology roadmap start with the dial-up days. I'm in the computer. And innovation of cable internet, innovation of fiber. So now in the cloud. So you can see the whole landscape. Without this fiber technology, this new digital highway we built, you cannot that have quality of connection. Digital broadband, digital communication nowadays is very essential. And if you notice, even you're rich or you're poor, no, they need a stable, high-speed, and quality connection. Right ng tao na meron access ng high quality of broadband. When there's a crisis, there's always have opportunity. So the pandemic hit us. This is a crisis the whole world. So that's why important you are really ready for your infrastructure. We found our service become a lifeline of the individual because of you need to have a quality and stable connection. And good thing, during this pandemic, we put more resources. This should be a right to aid individual usage, no? Regardless of what business you have, big or small. But if you ask me to advise SME how they can be successful in the business, number one, you need to have a passion in your business. Number two, you need to have a deep knowledgeable on your line of business. Don't come to the business you don't understand. They just tell you, oh, this kind of business is a follow. There is no such thing successful. You just follow someone. We link the whole country and this underserved and unserved area. We make sure by 2023 or 2024, we will reach them. We will give them a digital highway. The digital highway, we ask them to connect to the whole, not just on the Philippines, the whole world. This is the digital highway. Virtually, you can see, you can bring your business in virtual world. So that's the key role of the Converge now.
Welcome to Converge, Let's Talk Flexi Business. I'm Addie and I will be your host for today's very special event. Now, before we start with our program, I would like to remind everyone present in the Zoom to please rename yourselves in Zoom to your registered full name so we can identify you. So please be reminded as well to mute your microphone to avoid unnecessary noise during the program. So if any assistance is needed, you may chat with any of our co-hosts in the Zoom or simply type your questions in the chat box. Now, if you are all settled, let's begin. Magandang hapon ulit sa inyong lahat. Sana ay nakakain na kayo ng lunch ninyo. Sana na-enjoy nyo yung inyong break. And I see that we have a lot of guests today. And of course, we want to know, ano kaya ang ating mga guests ngayon? Ayan. So alamin natin yan. Mag-attendance check muna tayo. So type in the chat box kung taga saan ka at kung saan kilala o sikat ang lugar ninyo. Sample. Mag-sample muna ako. Ako, taga Quezon City po ako. And of course, kilalang kilala kami kasi ang laki-laki talaga ng city namin, o, diba? So, Quezon City really is a really, really big city. Ayan. So, kayo, gusto ko malaman anong city kayo galing and saan kilala ang city nyo. Ayan, mag-get to know you tayo ngayon. Of course, because we want to know. Ayan, meron na tayong mga sagot. So, we have Jessica from Cagayan de Oro. Wow. So, Jessica, ano yung, what is CDO known for? Ayan. So, we also have Rafael, he is from the Marcos Province. Wow naman. So we also have Joanna from San Juan, Batangas. And we also have, so we have Redel Belizardo, sabi niya, Baras, magaganda kami. Ay, parang gusto ko dyan. Gusto ko sa city mo. So we also have Kenley from Pasig City. Ayan, madami rin taga Quezon City. Wow naman. We have someone from Antipolo. NCR, Bicol, wow naman, ang dami-dami niyong, well, we have also Ilocos Sur, Oriental Mindoro, wow, ang dami-dami talagang nag-attend today, and we have so many, you're from different areas, alright, so thank you, of course, for all of your wonderful answers. Now, if you have noticed, every one of us has their own different answer of what is popular in our community. So for some, di ba, like me, is it the size of the city? Yung iba naman, magaganda daw yung mga nasa city nila, di ba? So what is common among all of these is that it is not fixed. So there will always be something new that emerges, new trends that develop as time marches on, as they say. Now, businesses today must now learn to adapt to these changes and know how to stay one step ahead of the trends and the competition. Now, with the proper knowledge and skills, one can easily learn the trends and analyze the competition. But to emerge on top requires something more. It requires the mindset of a champion and a challenger, one who is ready to succeed, to fail, and to bounce back. That is why today we are going to know more about the next normal leadership in today's topic, Think Ahead, Be a Data-Driven Entrepreneur. We also have a very special promo for today where those who apply during today's event will get free installation service. All about what a great deal. Interested applicants must fill out the application form and submit requirements within 7 days to avail of free installation promo. So you guys must be part of the registration database to qualify. Now, for viewers who are interested to apply for Converge Internet, we will also be discussing more details later in our breakout session. Please express your intent to apply and ask your queries to our Converge representatives in the breakout session. And of course, we are also going to have a raffle draw where we will be giving away a lot of prizes. So today, we will be giving away 1,000 worth of EGCs each. EGCs to one lucky winner. Isn't that exciting? And on top of that, we will be giving away a major prize of 3,000 worth of EGCs to one lucky winner. Kaya abangan nyo yan mamaya. And we also have a feedback form that we encourage everyone to answer in the latter part of the program. Now, those who will fill this out will get a chance to win 1,000 worth of EGCs. And remember that substance is key, all right? So only the feedback with substance will actually be qualified for this giveaway. So don't forget to put some thought into the form when you submit it at the end of the program. And of course, gusto mo na lahat kayo may chance talaga kayo manalo ng ating 1,000 GC with this feedback form. So dapat talaga malaman-laman talaga yung feedback. Kasi of course, we want to know ano ba yung insight nyo, what did you think, diba? So we want to know. So if you want to win, so dapat talaga malaman-laman talaga yung ating feedback form, okay? Madami po tayong prizes, games, raffle, ang daming pangyayari today. So don't worry, you all have a chance to walk away with prizes, okay? And don't forget to like and follow our Facebook page that is Converge for SME for more business tips and updates. All right, and now to officially welcome all of you, let us give a virtual round of applause to the National Sales Director for SME, Sir Eldridge Blue Aldridge.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon, and thank you very much for joining us today. My name is Blue Aldridge, and I'll be spending a short time with you just to extend ang buong pusong pasasalamat namin sa inyo na binigyan nyo ng pagkakataon ang Converge ICT na makasama nyo sa paglago ng iyong negosyo. So kinikilig po ako kasi nakikita ko mula bawat bahagi ng Pilipinas, may mga representatives tayo all the way from Mindanao, all the way from South Luzon, North Luzon, kompletong-kompleto po tayo. And para makwento ko po sa inyo, nagsimula po kami nito, halos 17, 20 attendees lang po. And right now, we have close to 130 attendees sa session natin. And this is something we do monthly. Iba't iba po ang topics, kaya po kung sa susunod, maimbitahan po kayo para pumasok sa educational series na to sa mga negosyante at mga institutional accounts. But before I start, I just like to say hello to some guests. Mr. John Ayorn de Mesa, IT Head of Lucena City Government. Good afternoon po sa inyo. Eleanor Honrales of Moonwalk Elementary School. Micasel Annex, thank you. From the Immaculada Concepcion College of Soldier Hills, Caloocan City, Incorporated, Mr. Jonathan Pariente. Good afternoon. Amor's Bakery, Ms. Zalom Amor, Escocia. From AFP EBSO, Mr. Joseph Alcarde. Good afternoon po sa inyo. Mr. Edward Delorfino, LCC Bacolod. Good afternoon po sa inyo. Alan Supe and Diana Aporador of VCY Sales Bacolod. And finally, from Hotel Durban, Antonio Hoxon and BTI Payments, Ms. Lily May Warren. So, good afternoon sa mga bisita natin ngayon. So, I'll just give me a few minutes to share with you the good news for this afternoon. So, let's talk about the fiber state in the Philippines. Because, alam mo, in a developing, well, a bit about myself, I'm happily married, father of three, I'm a Christian. And I've been bringing technology to businesses for the past 28 years. So I've been with software and hardware. And that's my passion, to bring technology to better the lives of people. So pag-usapan kasi natin, sometime in 2017, there was a survey done. And because of the infrastructure in the Philippines, no, 2017, we were ranked as number 100 out of, you know, a lot of Asia-Pacific countries. Number one was South Korea, then we have Singapore, Japan, Taiwan. All the way down, Sri Lanka had a better bandwidth than us, Indonesia and China. So we were in a very difficult situation that our internet infrastructure was not at the level of our Asian Pacific neighbors. So a lot has happened since then. A new player came in. A new player aggressively rolled out their brand new fiber infrastructure. And since then, we've been improving a lot in terms of internet speed infrastructure. So in this report, we were audited and it showed that, you know, dumoble naman yung speed ng Pilipinas mula ng 2016. So patuloy-tuloy po dahil sa pagpasok ng new player sa nagpo-provide ng fiber broadband. And the speed continued to climb. And wala pong katapusan yan. Hanggang ngayon, padagdag ng padagdag po ang bandwidth ng Pilipinas. And of course, coming from 5 Mbps, as of last 2001, they were showing that ang current average speed of fiber broadband in the country is at 50 Mbps. Okay, so sino po ba yung player na yan? That was Converge ICT. So in this age of connectivity, the value of data, the value of solutions, talaga pong tama ang sinabi ni Sir Dennis na wala pong maliit, wala pong malaki na negosyo, wala pong institusyon ang hindi dapat makapag-afford ng true fiber broadband. So a bit about Converge ICT, matagal na po kami sa industriya, 29 years. We have 3,000 employees. We are serving 1.8 million households. So I hope may mga bisita po tayo dito na naka-Converge ICT na sa bahay. At kung gusto nyo po mag-apply para sa bahay, sabihin nyo po lang ang mga representatives mamaya sa breakout section. Very proud to say that right now we have 55,000 institutions, businesses who are now happy customers of Converge ICT. We service the enterprise, government, public sector, and consumer space. And kasi ang walang pagod namin ginagawa ay yung pag-roll out. Gusto po namin lahat ng barangay sa Pilipinas malagyan ng sapat na fiber broadband connection. And napakabilis namin ginawa ito. In a span of 2 years, we have now reached 4.7 million fiber internet ports which were deployed. So, mula North Luzon, mula Cagayan Valley, all the way to General Santos, buo na po ang converged loop as of last year and continuously pa po namin pinapalago ito sa bawat sulok ng Pilipinas. So, aside from this, we have our own international gateways. Ang ibig sabihin lang po niyan is that kahit anong mangyaring undersea earthquake, kahit anong mangyaring underground disruption, there will always be a backup line. We have 5 backup lines to the international community. Kaya po kung ang linya papuntang US na putol, meron pa po tayong linya sa Taiwan, may linya sa Singapore, at sa Japan, at sa Hong Kong. So kahit anong mangyari, sabihin natin nagkaroon ng dalawang undersea earthquake, magka-problema ang kable, meron pa pong 3. Para tuloy-tuloy ang tuloy-tuloy ang internet connection. And one thing that we also do is that we have our own construction company, Metroworks. Sila po ang bahala sa mabilis na pag-roll out ng fiber connection. These boring machines nakikita niyo sa screen, they dig deep into the concrete, they lay the fiber connection, they also lay the cement that dries at a rate of 10 meters per hour. Marami po kaming ganyan and kaya po mabilis din ang paglaganap ng converged fiber internet. So of course, one thing that we also understand, given that our founder and visionary, Sir Dennis, had his roots, nagsimula po siya with very, very humble beginnings. As you can see, he started with a Betamax shop. So, ang host kasi natin, napakabata, hindi pa niya alam yung Betamax. Pero sa mga kaedad ko, yung Betamax yun po ang, that was the Netflix of my generation. So, right now, you just open your browser, you look at Netflix and you can watch. Before you had to go to a Betamax shop and rent the tape and put it in your Betamax player for you to watch. So our founder has his very humble beginnings in this Betamax shop that you see in the screen. That's why he understands, you know, the hardships and challenges of starting your own business. And what we want to do is to bring together SMEs and institutions nationwide, telling them about the good news that yes, there is affordable, powerful, and reliable fiber connections for your businesses. So, and this is part of that activity, this afternoon session of Let's Talk FlexiBiz. And, you know, through the years, a lot of solutions have sprouted. If you're into online selling, if you're into food, if you're into property rentals, content creation, or services, billions of dollars of research has been poured out for the adequate tools to make your business succeed. Okay, but without a proper fiber connection, which is the most powerful enabler, all these tools will not function well. So, very happy to say that it is our pride that we offer the best fiber connection to institutions and businesses nationwide. We want to assist in nation building through technological updates such as this. We want to build communities within the SME world. And of course, providing many, many opportunities for growth through various activities. So I'm about to wrap up my talk here, but just telling you that we service multiple industries: retail, education, LGUs, government, food establishment, manufacturing, financial services, and BPOs. And also we pride ourselves in utmost customer service. Ang mga salespeople na who handle your application, for any concerns, just reach out to them. And we pride ourselves of having very high satisfaction for our customer handling. So I'll end my slide with that and sit back, relax. This is a great time for you to learn more about true fiber connectivity. Marami pa pong mangyayari. May raffle po tayo. May free installation. We have breakout rooms. May games din tayo. So again, at this point, I'd like to say maraming salamat po for considering Converge ICT FlexiBiz to be your connectivity partner for your business, school, or government institution. So with that, I'm turning the floor over to AD and a pleasant good afternoon to all of you, our esteemed guests.
Sir Blue, for that very kind and insightful introduction. And of course, we would like to greet you a belated happy birthday, Sir Blue. We heard that you celebrated last week and we wish you good health, safety, and a happy and long life always. So happy birthday once again, Sir Blue. And now that we have heard from our national sales director, we have something to show you to officially introduce how Converge Business can help our SMEs. Everyone, let's watch this.
Introducing Converge FlexiBiz. Be in control with your daily connection needs for maximum productivity. With its time-of-day technology, you can boost your connectivity when you need it the most. Customize your connection's performance to fit your business needs. Have it at an all-time peak, or adjust speeds during hours of the day, whatever your business needs to support. Enjoy value for your money with a budget-friendly, reliable, and flexible package made for you. No data cap. Stream on pure fiber connection that you deserve.
This is perfect to manage our costs, especially if business is picking up.
Another thing that this pandemic has become an advantage on our end is it accelerated the need for this technology.
This is the kind of customized service that could turn trying times into thriving ones.
It is a worthy investment because it is made for us, for you.
Converge FlexiBiz. It's time to take control. Contact us to know more.
Video, and I'm sure that you all know the perks of having Converge. And as we live in the age of technological revolution, we need the most flexible internet to boost our productivity. And Converge offering such products is a great start. Hindi ba? So now it is time to learn more about our very special topic today and to provide us with the knowledge and power to succeed, let us welcome our very special guest, the COO of Malmisa Ventures Corporation, Marlon Malmisa.
Hi, hello, good afternoon, everyone. It's so nice to meet you, and we're represented, no, from different parts of the Philippines. And hello sa inyong lahat, hello leaders, hello entrepreneurs. It's so nice to get invited by Converge once again. And to some of you who attended the training, I think last week or last week, no, we discussed about how we can make our own business model in this pandemic season. And many people are asking me, hey, Sir Marlon, what will happen in the next coming years? So yung mga tanong nila, no? And is it good for us to put up a business, or how can I make my business pandemic proof? And we discuss about the ways for you to build your post-pandemic plan And just to have a recap, no, I shared three things. No, if you are an entrepreneur, if you are a business person, it is best for you to first, you know, think ahead, you know, think ahead. And we will discuss more about it. It's more of how to be a data-driven entrepreneur. And second is thinking across. You know, we say thinking across most great entrepreneurs that I know and most business people na highly performing, they are learners. No, they always learn from other people. And the third is think again. You know, think again, meaning to say we have to rethink our plans, our business models, but at the same time, stay on our being ethical and stay on our core. And ito, didiscuss natin ito isa-isa, but for now, we will focus in one area. And welcome to the masterclass. In 15 minutes, I'll try to discuss the best that I can. No? We will discuss the first think, okay? And this is what we call think again. Think ahead. All right. So think ahead is more of how you can see the future. And one of my most favorite books on leadership, the title is A Leadership Challenge. You know, this book is, I consider as the Bible of all leadership books. Why? Because it has a wide range of research on the qualities of leaders. And when they had the research, nagkaroon ng tanong and basic question, no, ano ang gusto mo sa isang leader? And when they went to different parts of industries, and I just want to focus in Asia lang, no, in Asia, and at the same time with the business sectors, you know, surprisingly, the top three, okay, the top three na parang people are admiring with the business persons, no, business people, is forward-looking. When you say forward-looking, he is able to see the future and he is able to create vision for the team. And these people and these leaders, business leaders, they are able to lead their people in that future. So that's why, you know, it's best that for us to be forward looking what will happen in the next coming years. You know, I remember there's a story, and this guy, his name is Jack Ma, no, in 2000 nagpumunta siya sa US, and pagpunta niya sa US, you know, he's a Chinese guy. Pagpunta niya sa US, na discover niya yung internet. So nung bumalik siya sa China, shinare niya yung idea ng internet, and the people were looking at him like, what? Okay, what's that? You know, ano yan? Isang malaking kalokohan yan, you know? And people were not believing that internet would be the next big thing. So that's why he was talking to business people in China, and nakarating siya ng US. And imagine that, no? Ang daming rejections. And for him, no? Crazy na babaliw si Jack Ma. But you know, after many, many years, no, right now, internet is a big thing. And that's why we have Converge, di ba? And why I'm sharing this with you is because sometimes people are looking at us na parang we have a crazy idea on our business. Na parang, oh, mag-work ba yan? You know, di ba? We have any question. We have all those questions. But I tell you, nasabi ni Steve Jobs na those people who have crazy ideas, no, and crazy enough to think that this will happen, and most of the time, no, they are the ones who change the world and change the landscape of the world. And that is why I tell you, if you have crazy ideas, you know, pray about it. Okay, pray about it. But here's the thing: it could make you a crazy person, okay, or it can make you or give you a crazy wealth. Okay, crazy money. That's why, maniwala kayo minsan sa crazy ideas ninyo. Pero many people are asking me, Sir Marlon, ba't ganun? Parang yung mga products ko or services ko, crazy nga siyang idea. Wala naman bumibili. Okay? But that's why, it is best that you have to make your crazy ideas also relevant. No? Like for example, this guy, no? This one is Scrub Daddy. Ayun yung pangalan ng kanyang sponge. And very simple. Imagine, sponge lang to, ha? And dinagyan niya lang ng muka. And imagine with that simple sponge, he was able to create wealth. In fact, in 2017, no, $100 million. Imagine, in 2019 was the peak of the Scrub Daddy, no? And imagine 200 plus million dollars, no, he was able to create. And it was featured in Shark Tank. You can watch it on YouTube, no, but imagine that, no, very crazy idea, but it is relevant. And when you say crazy ideas, importante din that it is relevant. And many people are looking at the future na very crazy, pero parang hindi ata kumoconnect sa reality. And that is why no, maraming mga failures pagdating sa mga startups, mga businesses na nagtatayo, is that they always create and provide products and services that people don't need. You know, I remember, maraming nagbebenta sa akin dati nung pandemic, di ba? Naglabasan lahat. Yung mga Shopaw, ano ba yun? Yung mga ube pandesal, okay? Pero, syempre, kaibigan mo, kailangan mong bilhin para lang at least matulungan sila. Pero pagkain mo, hindi masarap. Hindi man ako mahilig sa ganun, no? Pero imagine that. Imagine that, though, what I'm trying to say right now is that you have to make your business very, very relevant. And how you can create a relevant business model. And many people are asking me these questions then. No? How can I say na yung aking crazy ideas ay a need pa rin tomorrow? Yes, ngayon, need siya. Maraming bumibili. Pero in the next coming years, paano pa siya magiging need? Okay? And then many people are also asking me na parang what would be the best, okay, the best business idea for the next coming years. And that's why we're going to focus on thinking ahead. And thinking ahead. So what are the best practices for you to see what will happen in the future? And I tell you this, no, at babalik-babalikan ko kayo dito sa aking sagot. If you would ask me those questions, I could and I would always, always tell you, I do not know. Okay, hindi ko pa alam. All right, and I'm trying to figure out. Because with this kind of thinking, you know, I'm not being so confident because one of the pitfalls of the entrepreneurs is that they are very confident that this will happen. This will happen. This will happen. So gagawin nila, they will loan from a bank and ang nangyari, hindi pa lang yun. Okay? Because overconfidence could be also a threat, okay, for your business. That's why what I'm going to share with you is that how to be a risk taker but calculated. Okay, and that's why yung thinking ahead is not really about forecasting what will happen. It is actually about thinking, all right, thinking ahead through engaging with the people in a strategic conversations. We say strategic in quote and unquote is that meron tayong inaaral na aspeto ng business. That is why we are trying to figure out what will be the next big thing. Okay, and these are the four areas of conversations that you can start. No? Number one is that, you know, we have to look this in a perspective of behavioral economics. You know, right now, di po ako magtuturo ng economics. Okay? Kung kayo po ay nakaranas ng magkaroon ng economics, munti ka ko na po yan ibagsak ng kolehiyo. Okay? But when I had my master's degree, nung during my master's, nagkaroon kami ng subject entitled Applied Economics. And when I had this Applied Economics, doon ko na-appreciate yung tinatawag na behavioral economics. When I say behavioral economics, the basic question is more of if this will happen, okay? If this happens, what would be the tendency of people? Okay? So you have to ask yourself right now, no? What would be the tendency of the people? Like for example, no, the first time that the lockdown was announced, it is where I realized na people might go online. So what we did was very quick, we boosted their internet. Okay? Second is that we upgraded our technology. Third is that we invested with the high-tech, you know, technology so that, you know, so that we can give the best for our clients. So that's what we call thinking ahead, behavioral economics. So what are the areas that you have to look at? Okay, look up here, look up here. Listen to this. Number one is what we call socio-cultural environment. You know, one time I was able to get invited by one of the managers of former manager of this guy na this mall. You know this, hindi ko nababanggitin, nakita niyo naman po yung logo. But imagine he was able to see this from a kangkungan into an empire. So what did this, no? Ang ginawa ni Tatang, you know, I asked this mall manager, ano yung secret ni Tatang bakit naging ganito? Or Henry C, no? Bakit naging mayabong ang SM? And he shared to me na during that time, ang ginagawa lang pala ni Tatang, no? Ni Henry C is that nandun lang pala siya sa gitna, meron siyang notebook, sinusulat niya, okay? Yung behavior ng mga tao, okay? Napupunta doon sa kanilang maliit pa na mall, no? And imagine, at the time, that's what he called as the train spotting. And when you say trend spotting, these are the three things that you have to look at, okay? Like for example, what are the shared principles within that vicinity? Kung saan nyo tinayo ang inyong bakery, kung saan nyo tinayo ang inyong coffee shop, kung saan nyo tinayo, ano yung shared principle na nando sa paligid na yun? And second is that, ano yung relationship building nila? Are they into online or offline? Or, you know, and saan sila mas nag-i-engage? Like for example, this one, no, yung Kmart, yung Korean Mart, di ba? Bakit siya pumatok? Because nakita ng mga business owners na, oh, dumadami yung mga K-pop. Okay, you know, K-pop, the good work, all right? So imagine that. That is the secret. And dahil dyan, you know, pumapatok ang Kmart, ang Korean Mart, but what will happen in the next coming years? That's something that they have to look at again. Na parang in the next coming years, nandun pa rin ba yung intensity of mga Korean, all right? So, and that's what we call sociocultural. Right, and the second is that economic status. You know, if you watch this, no, ito yung pinaka sobrang favorite kong istorya, yung 2 pesos lang na lugaw. And sa 2 pesos na to, kumita talaga si Lolo. And when I learned about this story, inaral ko siya bakit siya kumita, because he applied this principle of trend spotting in terms of economic status. Number one, inaral niya kung sino yung nasa paligid. At yung mga nasa paligid, sila yung mga can't afford. Okay? Can't afford. That's why, sige, 2 pesos. And then, ginawa nila, inaral ni Lolo na saan ba madalas na bumibili? Ano bang binibili madalas nito? Hindi pala sila naka-after dun sa, ano, no, sa lugaw. Dun pala sila, yung mga tao sa paligid, naka-after pala or bumibili pala ng tokwat baboy. So gusto nila may tokwat baboy. That's why kumikita si Lolo doon sa tokwat baboy. And that's what we call spending behavior. You know, there are many people na kilala ninyo na parang sinasabi nila, naghihirap na ako pero naka-iPhone. Okay? So because that's what we call, spending behavior. And you also have to look at what we call the inflation. Okay? And you ask yourself, kapag tumaas ang bilihin, what will happen? Anong tendency na maging behavior ng mga tao? All right? And the third is this, technological capacity. When you say technological capacity, we have to look at this, no. Ito na share ko sa inyo, no. Yung I just want to give you one truth about this. Na parang when it comes to technology, there is no any other way but to really we're advancing towards it. Okay? So whether you like it or you like it more, okay? Yayakapin ng mundo ang technology. What is only thing is that gaano kabilis yumakap, okay, yung mga tao sa paligid ninyo sa technology. And when it comes to technological capacity, you have to ask yourself, no, yung sustained behavior. Ibig sabihin, ito dati offline sila pero offline pa rin ang gusto nila. All right? So probably online is not good for them. Pangalawa, transform behaviors. Sila yung mga dating offline pero meron ng element of online. Meron naman na parang collapse behavior, na parang ayaw na nila ng offline. Okay? Online na yung gusto nila. So you have to ask yourself, yung business model ko ba, nasaan dito sa tatlong ito? Okay? And that is why if there is what we call collapse behavior from offline to online, and there you have to call Converge. Okay? Magpakabit na kayo ng Converge. And that is where you can have your internet boosted. Kasi nga, doon na tayo papunta. And like for example, this one, oh, yung Zoom. And one time, I was invited to speak with the salespeople of real estate. And what they did was, they created, though, this one is a top real estate company, di ko nababanggitin yung pangalan, and they created an app, they created a virtual real estate, ano, parang virtual tour, and you know what they realized is that very, very prepared sila. Pero yung mga tao nila, yung mga clients nila, hybrid, okay? Mas gusto pa rin ng nakikita yung model, nakikita yung salesperson, so they want offline, all right? And because of that, no, nagkaroon sila ng another kind of business model na sige, i-hybrid natin. But there is one real estate company naman ako na mas gusto na nila yung online because their market is abroad. Mga OFW. So they are not able to go here in the Philippines, and because of inflation, you know, and because of inflation, and that's another behavioral economics. If, ang tanong is that, if tumaas ang dolyar kontra peso, ano ang tendency ng mga OFWs? And imagine, ngayon nakita ninyo, they want to invest in real estate here in the Philippines. So they want to invest in online na yung mga real estate. So imagine those things, no, that's what we call technological behavior. But last, no, before I end this, the last thing is that political climate. When you say political climate, okay, you have to look at these two areas. Yung priority policies ng gobyerno, yung economic plan ng gobyerno. All right? And you know, when I had this 2020, okay, during the time fresh pa yung pandemic, no. And I was talking to this conglomerate company, no, aming client, and I asked their HR. Sabi ko, "What are your top concerns? What are the top concerns of your employees with the work from home setup?" You know, ang number one, okay, na kanilang sinabi is internet connection. Okay, and sobrang bagal. You know, sino sa inyo, di ba? Parang talagang you would feel it, no? Sobrang parang pagumba to and all. But you know, when you talk about the policies, no, in the economic, the political climate, it means that supportive ba ang government na i-address yung concern na yon. Okay? So, when I learned that the government wanted to boost the internet through breaking the taxes, ibig sabihin parang tanggal ng mga taxes, they were very supportive. It's where I was thinking na sige, tuloy lang natin yung online. Okay, so if okay, during the time sinabi ng government wala tayong pondo diyan, hindi tayo, no, and yun yung parang mapapaisip ako na, oh, papakabit pa ba ako ng Converge? Okay, hindi na. Pero imagine during the time nakikita ako na parang the government was very supportive. So sige, let's be advanced and go where people will go. And aside from that, no, if I may end this, no, priority policies, second is economic plan, and last is what we call political agenda. And I want you to ask and reflect yourself, no, lalo na sa COVID. And this is very real in our industry, lalo sa training and learning development. People are still into parang online, pero at the same time, in person. Pero because of COVID-19, natitreaten sila na mag-create ng long-term plan. Okay? And for us, is that what we can only do is to maximize the online, pero at the same time, do short-term plan. So wala kaming long-term plans for the past few months. Pero every time na sinasabi ng mga local leaders, ng mga leaders natin sa government na, oh, wala nang lockdown, it's where the business sectors feel lang parang, okay, ano na tayo, let's have a long-term plan. So kami, is that we are now getting ready for that. So, and I would like you to ask yourself, no, like for example, yung inyong barbershop, okay, kung meron kayo tinatayong bakery and all, tanungin niyo yung sarili ninyo, supportive ba yung aking mayor, okay, na itayo ko ito? All right, sa economic plan nila. So with those three things, no, social, economic, technological, political climate, it's where you can create your strategic conversation, and it's where you can make your future plans. And I would like to end this with a quote from Steve Jobs na, we don't have the power to see the future, but sabi ni Steve Jobs is that you just have to trust that the dots of before will have somehow or will somehow connect with the future. And what you only have to do is to trust your guts, your feelings, and trust God above all. Because with everything, you know, we are data-driven, but above all, no, we plan, but the Lord approves. And be prayerful and know where you are going to. And with that, maraming salamat sa inyo. Hopefully, I was able to share a few things about thinking ahead. And I hope that to see you for the next session. And that is what we call Think Across. Thank you so much. And God bless you all.
Sir Marlon, for that very informative talk. And of course, I'd like to encourage everyone here to raise questions later para dun po sa mga gustong mag-put up ng business in the future sa ating Q&A segment mamaya. Also, alam mo, ang ganda talaga ng talk na to. I'm sure madami rin kayong natutunan. Ako, gustong-gusto ko talaga yung sinabi ng speaker natin na kailangan talaga crazy yung idea mo. Alam mo yun, it doesn't matter how crazy it is. Try it out. Baka gumana. Alam mo yung sinabi mo na 2 peso, yung 2 peso technique, parang gusto ko rin yun i-apply sa business ko and then really see if gaganda kaya siya and kung babalik-balik talaga yung customers ko. Alright, so now that you have heard from Marlon, it is now time for us to stretch our backs and relax with a game. Ayan, I'm sure na-excite lahat kayo kasi may game tayo ngayon. So here are the mechanics of our game. It is called Four Picks and One Word. So what I'll be doing is I will be showing you four pictures that all share a common word. So the goal is to find the common word based on the number of letters provided at the beginning of the game. So the word length will also be shown under the four pictures. So the first person to guess the word in the chat box wins the prize. So the correct word will be displayed once someone gets the right answer. Okay, so let's give you a little hint. Some words are related to Converge or relevant to the topic of today's event. Ayan, so kung nakinig kayo, kayang-kaya nyo talaga manalo sa game na to. Okay, so of course, I'm sure you wanna know our prizes. We will be giving away 3 500 pesos worth of GCs. Ayan, so 3 winners po yung makukuha natin sa game na to. Alright, so if there are no other questions or clarifications or anything, let's begin the game! Ayan, let me know in the chat box if ready na kayo for the game! Yes, okay, so let's see. Ayan, ang dami ng ready, let's go! So here is the first set of photos. Bilisan nyo yung mag-type. Ayan, mag-type lang kayo dyan. Unlimited guesses naman tayo ngayon. So let us see. Okay, so meron nang nakakuha ng tamang sagot. Okay, so let's bring it up. The answer is... Ayan, reveal na natin. The answer is leader. Okay, and the winner is Maricel Marasiga. Congratulations to our winner, Maricel Marasiga. You just got 500 worth of GCs. Ayan, ang bilis naman niya sumagot. Okay, so now let's bring out our next set of photos. Ayan. There you go. Oy, ang daming letters nito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. 10 letters po yung hinahanap natin ngayon. Okay. Okay, so someone got the answer right. The answer is innovation. There you go. And the winner is Ruby Ebid. Congratulations, Ruby. Ayan, second winner natin. Don't worry, guys. May isa pa rin. May isa pa rin tayong set of photos. Okay, let's bring out the last set of photos. Ayan. Oh, ang ganda. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. 6 letters. 6 letter word. Ayan. Ano kaya yung sagot dito? Go, mag-guess lang kayo. And may nakakuha na. Let's go. Let's bring out the answer. The answer is future. Ayan. Okay, and the winner is Aris Padilla. Woo! Congratulations. Wow, meron tayong 3 winners. So congratulations po to all our winners of the game. I hope you are all freshened up by our game. And of course, thank you so much to everyone for participating. Yung mga hindi pa nananalo, okay lang yan. Madami pa tayong exciting activities mamaya. Ay, may raffle pa tayo. Okay, so stay tuned. We also have a very special promo today where those who apply during today's event will get free installation service. Oh, diba? What a great deal. Interested applicants must fill out the application form and submit requirements within 7 days to avail of the free installation promo. So you guys must be part of the registration database to qualify. Now, for viewers who are interested to apply for Converge Internet, we will also be discussing more details later sa ating breakout session. So please express your intent to apply and ask your questions to our Converge representatives in the breakout session. Also, a reminder that we have a feedback form that we encourage everyone to answer after the program. The one with the winning feedback gets to win 1,000 worth of EGCs. And stay tuned because we still have a total of 5,000 worth of EGCs to give away later on. Kaya abangan nyo yan. Also, don't forget that we are on Facebook. You can like and follow our Facebook page. That's Converge for SME for more business tips and updates. And again, I just like to remind everyone present in the Zoom to please rename yourselves in Zoom to your registered full name so we can recognize you. Please be reminded as well to mute your microphone to avoid unnecessary noise during the program. Now, if you need any assistance with this, you may chat with any of our co-hosts in the Zoom or simply type your questions in the chat box. All right, so now let us hear stories naman from our satisfied customers and how Converge helped boost their business. Everyone, let's watch this.
So my name is Bianca Cortez, and I am part of a family business which is called Bianca's. We're a bakery in Delhi, as more of an online business. We've been around since 2016 and have been doing the business since to both customers, direct customers, and retailers. But pandemic happened, it's been 2 years, and well, praise God, we're able to still keep afloat in our business because we have done a lot of steps so that we are very much accessible online. Quite a few people would ask us, oh, how can I get your bread? Or is there a way that I can have my bread tomorrow and stuff like that? So we all had to learn how to navigate around what people want and what we are capable of also. Because we're still a small business, but thanks really to technology, it was a lot easier to coordinate a lot of things, from ordering your supplies online, from coordinating with the customer on what they want, delivering it through all the third-party couriers that are all online also. So all these different opportunities, you really just have to find a way to make it all work for you, because you know it's there. For us, it's very important that we have good internet, especially when we do the bookings also for our customers, because when we deliver to them, we have to make sure that we do it correctly and we do it on time, and we'll be able to do the multiple bookings properly also. Because if we can be very efficient in doing this, it also helps us with our operational costs, and also makes our customers happy because we're able to provide to them the service that they want in the best way we can.
Bianca Spread, and I'm sure marami sa inyo ang may mga questions for all the information presented today. That is why we are now going to proceed with our Q&A session. So you may type in your questions in our chat box. So if you have any questions, now is the time to do so. And for this segment, we will be welcoming back our speaker to answer your queries. So may we please welcome back on screen, Sir Marlon.
Hi, hello.
Hello, Sir Marlon. How are you doing?
Hi, hello. Yeah, I'm good. Very hectic schedule, pero I love to see our SME warriors here.
Yes, it's really great that you are here to help all the potential business owners, all right? Okay, so now we're going to be asking you some questions. So the first one is, what is the simplest way to have and analyze data?
Yeah, I think yung researching skill is actually a discipline, you know, and there's no any other easy way for you to do this. Yung researching is not easy in a sense na you have to, like, you're searching like a gold, like you're searching a gold, eh. So talagang mahirap talaga siya. But there are easy ways that you can, yung practical ways, like for example, subscribing to Business Harvard Review, and McKinsey, these institutions, they provide data, and at the same time, ini-interpret na nila. So in a sense, that's the one of the easiest way for you to, you know, di ka na mahirapan ba? Okay, pero it's a good discipline that you also analyze it on your own, and also verify if it is really working in your own context. Kasi mostly mga Western kasi yung mga approach nila. So what if here in the Philippines, nag-work ba siya? So that's our role.
Yes, that is so true. It's very important to really get data and try to apply it to your own business as well. Okay, so our next question is, why is it important to have an awareness on the spending behavior of an individual before opening a business?
Yeah, I think there is a secret with impulse buying. So because people are emotional, and even researches about sales, people buy based on emotions. So that is why it is translated to the spending behavior of people. So like for example, meron ako dati na isang client, is company sila na nagbebenta ng popcorn, and during that time pinwesto nila yon sa normally sa gilid ng cinema. Pero ang nangyari is that when they started to open their popcorn store sa mga community, lalong-lalo na kapag katabi ng milk tea, bumenta. So during the pandemic, mas bumenta. So that's what we call the spending behavior. No? Parang after you buy the milk tea, napapaisip sila na, uy, gusto ko ng maalat. So okay, siguro yung popcorn. So ayun yung spending behavior. Parang, and that is very important to note. Yung spending behavior is connected with the impulse buying of the people. So if you know that, you can maximize it.
Yes, that's really great advice. Actually, feeling ko ako yung tipong kukuha ako ng milk tea tsaka popcorn at the same time, diba? Para sweet and salty din.
Yeah.
Okay, so our next question is, what are the tips that you have for business owners when it comes to choosing what type of business they should open?
Yun yung isa sa pinaka mahirap sagutin, no? Pero ako personally, I want you to go back to the basic. Recently, I was talking to human resource, and they were discussing about the quiet quitting thing. Yung quiet quitting, sabihin nun, yung mga employee daw ngayon, bare minimum na lang yung ginagawa. That's quiet quitting. So when they found out, no, paano sila mamomotivate, they shared about the 3 P's, no, which is play, passion, and potential. So I think if we're going to apply this in business, it is also helpful. So ano yung play, no? Play, ibig sabihin, ito yung you enjoy just doing business. You know, you just enjoy what you're doing. So importante, if you put up a business, you enjoy it. Na parang as if you're just playing in the playground. Pangalawa is that through that business, you see your purpose. The reason why you're existing, and with that purpose, mas manamomotivate ka na ituloy kahit na nalulugi, basta ituloy natin. May ganang driving force. And the third is potential. Potential is more of how that business will improve you. Okay? So in a sense, you will take a risk, pero you know sa sarili mo na this business will improve me. In terms of my communication skill, in terms of my capacity, my grit, my passion, everything, no, it will really make you better person. So yung tatlong piece na yon are positive motivators. Meron kasing tatlo pa na na-discuss, which is the social emotional pressure. Ginagawa mo isang bagay kasi kapag hindi mo siya ginawa, merong effect sa'yo emotionally, negatively. Meron naman economic pressure. Kaya ka nagbi-business kasi gipit ka. Okay? So, and inertia. Yan na, nagbi-business ka kasi wala lang. Parang try ko lang. So, ang punto lang dito is that negative motivators. So, go to the positive motivators, which is the 3. So, if you put up a business, dapat it should make you just, you know, play, purpose, and potential.
Yes, thank you so much for that. Parang life advice na rin yung ginawa mo, diba? You just have to stay positive, do everything you can, kahit currently nagfa-fail yung business mo, if you believe in it, kayang-kaya talaga. Yes, gusto ko yung advice na yan. So our next question is, as business owners, what do we consider, what do we need to consider to learn in order for us to know if it's okay with the market? Let me rephrase the question. So yeah. Do we consider to really learn or to know if the business that we are about to offer is something that the market will be okay with?
Yeah. I think if yung sa tanong na yan, isa sa naalala ko is when I was invited in a particular school, I forgot kung UST ata yun, and I had my co-speaker during the time was RJ Ledesma. RJ Ledesma was the founder of Mercato. So, and then he was sharing about the model of Mercato, and sabi niya, yung Mercato is what we call the testing ground. Before you put up a full-blown restaurant, itry mo muna sa Mercato. And I think that's the best business advice that I could share with everyone. Na if you are planning to make parang bakery, wag ka muna mag-bakery, start small. Dream big but start small. Pwede ka munang magbenta, mag-bake on your own, and then ipatikim mo sa mga kaibigan mo. Or yun nga, you can, you know, have a booth sa isang maliit na space, tapos aralin mo lang siya. So start small, okay? And it's best to dream big, pero kung inuunti-unti mo siya, doon ka mas magiging practical sa mga bagay-bagay. So, yun lang. Dream big and start small.
Yes, that's actually really good advice para matest mo rin yung market mo, di ba?
Yeah.
Okay, so let us go on to our last question. So, how does the economic plan contribute to my business success?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think we have to look at our business as a part of the bigger pie. And yung business is only part of a bigger picture wherein yung government natin or our economy is that bigger pie. So ibig sabihin, one movement in our economy has an effect to another aspect, not only business, no, but also with the religious sector, with the educational institution. So, ang punto lang dito is that it's best that we have to consider what's happening in the economy kasi it has a ripple effect, no, sa business natin. So, ang tanong na lang dyan is, yung movement ba yon sa business na yon is magiging negative or positive? But I think most of the entrepreneurs that I know, they are positive thinkers. And they call this na parang crisis, na sabi ng mga Chinese, crisis has two meanings. Sabi nila, it's a threat, danger, and at the same time, it's an opportunity. So that's why if there is a movement in the economy na negative, look at the positive side of it and maximize it. Like for example, what I've shared kanina, tumataas ang dolyares. Okay? So it's where you go abroad, you know, expand. Go to another country, go to Southeast Asia muna, no? Na nagbabayad ng dolyares so that you do your business here and then malaking income mo kasi dollars yung binibenta sa iyo. So, I think that's the entire picture, no, of our economy, and that is very important to know para you can plan ahead.
Okay, thank you so much for that piece of advice. And of course, we have come to the end of our Q&A segment. Do you have any last pieces of advice for everyone today?
Yeah, and I think yun lang, no, tama yung sinabi ni ng ating host kanina, no, ni Adi, if you reiterate yung if you have crazy ideas, sometimes you have to trust your guts and feelings. But at the same time, I would like to excite you on our second part. It's more of thinking across, because if you have crazy ideas and you validate it with other people, I tell you, you can be unstoppable. So that's where you have to just find that perfect fit persons in your company. So yeah, keep dreaming and be data-driven always.
Yes, thank you so much. And that wraps up our Q&A segment. Thank you for joining us today, Sir Marlon.
Thank you so much. Maraming salamat.
Yes, thank you, thank you. And we are now going to move on to our breakout sessions. Now with this, we have our facilitators to lead each breakout room. We have our representatives here who will be answering all of your questions today. So feel free to ask questions as we put each of you to your respective breakout rooms. And of course, we will be having our raffle segment later on. So please be back here in the main room after your breakout session. So we will now be inviting you to your breakout rooms. Please accept the invitation that pops up on your screen and proceed by clicking join. Now, if you miss the prompt, all you have to do is to look for the breakout session icon below and click on the room you want to join. So when the time is up, we will be closing the breakout room and you will automatically be brought back here to our main room. So please don't leave the meeting or you might miss out on our raffle, okay? Clear na clear ba yon? All right, so everyone, let us start with our breakout session. So we will see you all back here in the main room later on.
Bitch I've ever known. feeling even stronger than I've ever felt before. Push me to the limit, now I'm in a different zone. Now you're all alone, now you're all alone. And I know that I was always good to see it, and I fell into the games that you were playing. Yeah, you were the person I've been, but you never see me like this. One little while, I feel so missing. Yeah, you imagine, I know you're gonna hate it. Now I got the power and I claim it. So baby, read my lips. I say, no, no, no. I say yes too many times. I was no, no, no. Told you I'm no longer under your control. Oh, oh, no, I'm not the kind of girl I was before. You're going with me no more, no more, 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 more. No, no, no. I say don't, don't any time. No, no, no. Told you.
Yeah. side. Little trust and some passion be nice. It's all I desire. I need it, I cannot deny. Oh, hey, I don't see something. For my eyes only. You know emoji. Show me a little bit dance. A little bit dance. Show me a dance. Show me a little dance. Oh no. Show me a little dance. Lately I've been losing my mind. Certain things I can't find. In the middle of the night. I'm still up, I'm still tryna decide. Should I drink up, smoke up, need some freedom, freedom in my life. Should I drink up, smoke up, need some freedom, freedom. Show me a little attention. A little bit
I told you that I never would. I told you I changed. Even when I knew I never could.
Thank you so much to our dear representatives for taking the time to join us today. Now, I hope you all learned a lot and enjoyed our breakout sessions. So we have now come to the most awaited part of our program, the raffle draw. Ayan, ito na. Yung hinihintay talaga ng lahat. And of course, may mga mechanics po tayo. So first off, you must be present here in our main room to qualify for the raffle. So if you see your names on screen, you may type here or present in the chat box so we can see you. Now, if not, we will have to redraw and pick a new possible winner, okay? Clear na clear ba yung ating mechanics? Yes, let me know in the chat box kung clear na po and ready na kayo sa ating raffle draw. Ayan, aba, may mga nag-ano na present, clear, tama yan. Pero pag nanalo lang kayo, ah. Also, a reminder that your names in the Zoom should be renamed to your registered full names so we can recognize you, okay? So I won't keep you guys waiting any longer. Mukhang ready na talaga kayo. So for this first raffle draw, we are going to be giving away 1,000 worth of EGCs to one lucky winner. Okay, so I'm sure you guys are all excited for this. So let's start. Let us bring out our wheel of names. Ayan, lahat po ng names nyo. We put it in this wheel. And now we're gonna pick a possible winner for our 1,000 worth of EGCs. All right, so let's spin that wheel. All right, so let us see. Remember, if you let us know in the chat box that you are here and that you are present. All right, let's see. The winner is John Vincent Escobedo. Yeah, John if you are here. Let us know in the chat box. Okay. Oh, wala daw si John. Okay, let's go to the next possible winner. Remember, pag nakita nyo pangalan nyo, Okay, let's see who the winner is. Grabe yung suspense ng wheel na to, ah. Okay, the winner is... Philmar Guerrero! Ayan, so Philmar Guerrero, if you are still here, let us know in the chat box that you are here, you are present. Okay, so let's see. Mag-chat ka lang dyan, bilisan mo! Okay, ayan! May nag-message si Philmar! He is from LGU Palawan. Wow, okay. So, congratulations to you! You just won 1,000 worth of EGCs. Okay, so now I'm sure you're all excited for
our next week.
One, okay. So for our major prize, we are getting 3,000 worth of EGCs to one lucky winner. Okay. So let's see. Let's bring out our wheels. Sino kaya mananalo nito? Remember, kapag nakita niyo yung name niyo. Now, you just have to chat that you are here and that you are present. Okay? So, let's see. Sino kaya mananalo ng 3,000 worth of EGCs? Ayan. Let's see. Let's roll that wheel. Okay. So, let's see. Remember, if nakita nyo pangalan nyo galing sa wheel na to, yes, let us know in the chat box that you are here and that you are present. Oh, si Ricky! Oh, walang last name si Ricky. Okay. Ricky Martin, if you are here, let us know in the chat box. Okay, so let's pick another winner. Parang wala, si Wella tsaka si Roland yung nagpa-present eh. Okay, so let's pick the next possible winner. Let's roll that wheel. Let's roll it. Remember that 3,000 worth of EGCs is what we are raffling off right now. Ang dami nito, pang shopping talaga. Okay, so let's see. The winner is Rodora Oliva. Ayan, nakita man ang name na to. So Rodora Oliva, if you are here, if you are present, let us know. Okay, wala daw siya. Okay, so let us pick a next possible winner. Ayan, may chance pa kayo. Let's roll that wheel. Ayan. Let's see. And the winner is... Kaya mo yan, wheel. Sino yung winner? Si Ariel Constantino. Okay. Ariel Constantino. Oh, wala daw si Ariel. Okay, so let's see. Who is our next possible winner? Grabe, may chance pa kayong lahat kasi hindi po present yung ating mga. Okay, so let's see who is the next possible winner. And the next possible winner is Janina Velasquez. Ayan. So Janina, if nandito ka, let us know if you are here. Okay, wala daw si Janina. Let's pick the next possible winner. Sino kaya yung mananalo? Let's roll that wheel. Ayan. So let us see. Sino yung mananalo ngayon? Sana present po yung winner na to. Okay, so let's see. Who is our winner? So we have Ginaline Calabia. Yes, Ginaline. Okay, so wala daw si Ginaline. May chance pa kayo. Okay lang yan. Okay, let's roll that wheel. Let's see who will win our grand prize of 3,000 worth of EGCs. Grabe, sana ako na lang to. 3,000, ang dami na to, ha? Okay, and the winner is Gerald Imperial. Okay, Gerald, sana nandito kayo. Oh, wala daw si Gerald. Okay, let us pick the next possible winner. Ayan. So let's spin the wheel. Let's spin it. Let's see. Alright. Sino kaya mananalo dito? And the winner is Solomon Manuel. Okay. Solomon Manuel, are you here? Are you present? Let us know in the chat box or else pipili kami ng ibang winner. So once again, we'd like to invite Solomon Manuel to let us know. Ayan, nandiyan si Solomon! Solomon B. Manuel! Ayan, congratulations to you, Solomon! You just won 3,000 worth of EGC. So congratulations to all our raffle winners. And don't worry, a Converge representative will be sending you an email within 24 hours to give you details on how to claim your prizes. So congratulations po sa inyong lahat. And yung mga hindi pa nananalo, okay lang yan. Because the winner of the last 1,000 worth of EGCs is the one with the most winning feedback. Okay, so we encourage everyone to answer our feedback form right after this event. So we would like to get everyone's feedback and insight. So please do answer the feedback form. Just scan this QR code flashing on screen. And of course, this is because our team will be screening all of your feedback, and you will receive an email from our Converge representative after the show if you are the winner of our 1,000 worth of EGCs. All right. So that was a jam-packed program, and I'm sure you guys all enjoyed today's event as much as I have. We also have a very special promo for today where those who apply during today's event will get free installation service. Oh, diba? What a great deal. Interested applicants must fill out the application form and submit requirements within 7 days to avail of free installation promo. So you guys must be part of the registration database to qualify. Now for viewers who are interested to apply for Converge Internet, you can also contact us if you would like to get Converge Internet right now. And you can also like and follow our Facebook page that is Converge for SME for more business tips and updates. So there you go. We have now come to the end part of our program. And as we have all learned today, as times change, more and more avenues for us to expand our businesses will continue to arise, which is why it's important to innovate and provide new ways to stay connected. One thing that will never change, however, is our need for steady connection. And with Converge, we can help you maintain constant communication with your audience, continuous creation and consumption of content, while providing you immediate support for your needs. Thank you again for joining us today here at Converge Let's Talk FlexiBIZness. Once again, my name is Addie, and I want to thank each and every one of you for joining us today. We hope you had a great time, and we hope you all have a great, great day. Bye!